Welcome back to Norfolk Perspectives, and I have the first citizen sitting on the sofa, and I realized when I did the pre-tease and said Congressman Whitehurst that I forgot that Randy Wright was with him. How you doing, Randy, former council member?
Doing good.
And president of the Cosmopolitan Club.
Right.
Yep. You want to introduce our guest of honor here?
Well, it's an incredible honor for me, and I got to tell you, one of the things that every time I have the opportunity to be with Dr. Bill, I learn something new about him. And when we told him about the selection committee's choice during the course of the conversation, he mentioned to me that he was appointed by Governor Blouse to the first board of the Virginia Lottery in 1988. And lo and behold, near and dear to my heart, being the new deputy director of Virginia Lottery, and I tell you, they laid the foundation of the integrity and credibility and all that stands there today. So with that, I want to introduce him not only as a congressman, but being on the first board of the Virginia Lottery appointed by a Democratic governor.
So he's a boss emeritus then?
Yeah.
So how's he doing?
He's doing fine.
I just thought I'd check. Okay, and Randy brings up a good point. I mean, how should I be introducing you? We got your honor, the congressman, but you, there's people out there who are watching and say, no, that's not Congressman Whitehurst, that's Professor Whitehurst.
Well, yes, call me Bill is what I tell people. And my students call me Dr. Bill, generally. And I don't go by the congressional title anymore. There's just no need to. I've been gone from Congress over 28 years.
No.
Oh, yes. And I retired.
For some of us, it seems like it's just yesterday. And boy, did we miss you.
It seems like yesterday to me.
Time flies.
Yeah.
Now, I also have to say that, and I shared in pre-tape, but we also talk about you twice a year on the show when they come on from St. Patrick's. Evening classes, because you're the star professor for that, too.
Well, it's a lot of fun to go over there, and of course, we raise some money for the school. And the last lecture I had was Everybody Loves Dirt, Congressional Scandals, and that'll get people out in a heartbeat.
Yeah, well, then I think you had a couple of years ago, what about the communists? I think the year before last?
Yes,
I wonder, are you allowed to teach these classes at ODU, too, though?
Well, I'm on the faculty there, and I teach a couple of classes, one in political science and one in history. So I had occasionally mentioned scandals, of course, my Kings of the Hill class, but which is about the speakers, we mentioned scandals. Cool. But there's a lot more to it than that. That's just, you know, for show.
Now, on a day-by-day basis, though, you are constantly keeping an eye on how things are going in Norfolk.
In Norfolk?
Yeah, how are they coming in Norfolk?
It's a great city. I was born and raised here. I'll be 90 years old in March. I've seen a great deal. And it was a dirty seaport town, and it's been changed. We've had good leadership in this city. Fred Duckworth, our current mayor, Paul Frame. When you look at the things they're doing, and when Randy was on the city council, that he did. In fact, we have the tide now primarily because of his efforts. There have been people who have a vision for this city and seen that vision fulfilled. And so when I look at Norfolk, particularly downtown Norfolk, from where I live at Harbor's Edge, up on the 13th floor, 15th floor rather, and I see the panorama, I'm just struck by it because I recall how things were once. And we had crime, it was bars along East Main Street. It was not a city you could be proud of, but it's one today I think is a real jewel.
You mentioned that word vision, and I asked the same question of the mayor when they opened up the courthouse. Some of these visions, though, and Randy, you know this too. I mean, some of these visions are so long-term.
Yes.
And that it almost seems like a generation or cycle, 12 budget cycles before something comes around. How do you maintain that patience in that leadership role?
You just strive, and maybe Randy can answer that better than I can.
Yeah, I mean, obviously the tide was a vision. There were a lot of people who said, can't happen. So, but we tend now to
14 years in the making.
Right. And yet we tend to look at things on an annual basis now. You got to get it done by the end of the year. Or we have a Congress we have a Congress with no budget.
Yeah.
I mean, so how do we get back on track? Pardon the pun, Randy.
You struggle.
Yeah.
And you persist. And you hope to get people behind you. And then finally the project comes to fruition. It's realized, just as it was with the tide. Mm. 14 years you spent on it. That's amazing, Randy.
Wow.
It really is.
Yeah. So tenacity.
Yes, tenacity. And you just, nothing's done in a day. I can tell you, being in Congress for 18 years, it isn't. I was in the Armed Services Committee developing new weapons, for example. It was a matter of people who felt they had the technological ability to produce a better aircraft, for example, and persuaded the Congress to do it. And I just think of a lot of things that were done. I think my own district, things that I wanted to get done here. Mm-hmm. For example, I was able to push through and get the appropriation for the Navy to acquire the property owned by the Norfolk Western. When you drive down Tossing Boulevard today, it's no longer a three-lane road. It's a beautiful project, isn't it?
Yeah.
I can take credit for that.
So it's a matter of putting those building blocks in place to
Absolutely.
Bring that vision alive.
Absolutely.
Okay, let's talk now about the big dinner coming up. Randy,
well,
now's the time to sell tickets.
Well, let me tell you, anybody that sees this show still has time to and all they got to do is to go to NorfolkFirstCitizen.com. NorfolkFirstCitizen.com. March the 7th is when we're going to have this event. It'll be at Norfolk Yacht and Country Club. There's still time to get on board. And I got to tell you this. I asked Dr. Bill in our first conversation, I said, you have any idea how many young people you have taught over your lifetime? And I said, it's probably a few thousand. He said, I can tell you exactly how many it is. 10,182 or something close to that. Over 10,000.
Hey, that's a lot of tickets for this dinner.
So listen, there are 10,000 people that are out there that are hearing this. This is your chance.
It's close to 10,000.
To get on board.
It's not over 10,000 yet.
To get on board and pay tribute to what I think is one of Norfolk's true statesmen that I've had the honor and privilege to interact with over the last 35 years, and I've really enjoyed it immensely. I've learned a lot from him, and having him as a mentor and a friend that I could go to on different times and say, hey, what do you think about this or that? And you know, as he said, nothing happens fast, and that's a hard thing when you're used to the private sector and you get into the public arena. And for those who think that the cure-all is term limits, if you had term limits, you wouldn't get anything
That's
done.
Right, because it does take a long time. Did you notice what he just said? It's not 10,000 yet.
Yeah.
And this was five minutes after you announced you're going to be 90 years old.
I'm working on it. I'm still teaching.
That is so cool.
Yeah. It's,
Okay, you mentioned the website, and I would also encourage people to get you off the hook, because I want to close out the show by having you start listing from the 80-some years ago. But we won't do that. Go to, what's the website again?
NorfolkFirstCitizen.com.
So,
and the whole list is there, and come on aboard.
Thank you for agreeing to be our first citizen. But I tell you what, Congressman Bill, Dr. Bill, you have been our first citizen for many, many a year.
Thank you very much. So generous of you to say that.
We want to hear from you, what you'd like to see on TV 48. But more importantly, what's going on in your neighborhood? Give us a holler at 664-6510. And as usual, it's a wonderful time to be in Norfolk just because of you. And you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.